Yo guys, what is going on? Mortex Sir here. I just wanted to put a really quick video together to show you how to load PS2 games on the Retroid Pocket 2 via the steamlink. I've been doing this with the PCSX2 and it's been running really smooth. I've been playing with it for the last couple of days, so I just wanted to do a really quick video to show you how to do this so you can enjoy some of the classic PS2 games on the Retroid Pocket 2. So if you want to know how to actually put your PS2 ROMs into Steam, then you need to download. You can do it a couple of different ways. You can do it as a bat file or you can download a program. I use Steam ROM Manager. It's pretty self-explanatory. I'm not going to explain that today. I will do a video on it for you guys if you do want me to do it, to explain how to run it. It is pretty straightforward though. Just read the instructions and you should be able to get all the games loaded onto Steam. Now what we'll do is we'll move on to the actual Steam settings for the Steam Link so we can get the Retroid Pocket 2 to pick up as a controller. So we are on the PC, so the first thing you need to do is go to settings and then go down to remote play. Then you need to put enable remote play and the device should show up. If it doesn't show up for some reason, you need to go onto allow direct connection and go onto all devices. Then once you go into the Retroid Pocket 2, load up Steam Link and then you should get a confirmation code. This will be normally a 4-digit, 5-digit number. You will have to hop back onto the PC, put that code in, then that's how it will link these devices together. So that's done. I don't really mess about with anything else on here, so that's done. So as I mentioned in the title, we have got PS2 games running on the Retroid Pocket 2. So I'm going to show you how to do this. Firstly, you need to download the PCSX2. I'm not going to show you how to download this today. I've actually got a video. It should be coming up in the top right now, and it's also in the description below how to install this on the PC. So go and check that out. But all we need to do is go on config. We go down to control and then plugins. Now, this is what it will look like. This is the lily pad and this is what the settings will look like. Now, you need to do one thing on this to actually get the Retroid Pocket 2 to detect the PS2 control bindings, or what the Steam Link actually thinks it is, which is a PS3 controller. You need to take the X put out. This is for Xbox 360 and Xbox One controllers, and it does interfere with the digital stick, so it makes the digital stick drift left constantly. So we take that off, we keep direct input on, and then we press apply and OK. And that should help stop the stick from drifting. Now, I've got some examples of games that we sideloaded through the Steam Link now. So we've got SSX Tricky. We've got a bit of Scarface as well. Now, the picture quality isn't great because I'm recording off the phone onto the screen. But trust me, the quality is really good when you're actually playing it on the Retroid Pocket 2. It's really smooth. I've had no problems at all. It would be really ideal to get this running on the Retroid Pocket 2, but in a real world, we need a more powerful chip, which the Retroid Pocket 2 just doesn't have. So this is an alternative, and you can do this for a lot of different emulators as well. And don't forget, please like, rate, and subscribe, and hit that bell notification button to get all the new and latest videos. Until next time, as always, I'll see you soon.